Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Jeniffer and I do vlogs. I am starting off this vlog in my bathroom because this vlog is going to be a glow up with me for summer. And today I need to do my everything shower. If you're a girl, you know what that means. Hair, body, shaving, all of it. I'm gonna start with that, then I'm gonna get out and do my full skincare routine for you guys, along with some extra stuff that I don't really do all the time, but I want to glow up for summer, so we're gonna do some extra stuff. I'm gonna whiten my teeth, I'm gonna do a face mask, and then I will continue the days with other things I'm gonna get done. I need my nails done, my lashes done, and I'm getting a little bit of Botox this time. So let's start with the shower. Step one, before I get in, I am going to use a coconut oil serum. I'm going to put this all over my hair, let it set for 30 minutes, and then jump in and rinse it off. I feel like I really need to take care of my hair. I just dyed it a couple months ago and my hair already looks pretty dry to me. I don't have oily hair at all, and it has been a week since I washed it, so it really doesn't get oily. So I want to put some coconut oil in it just to refresh it and get it looking healthy. I am going to apply a decent amount, starting with the middle of my hair down to the ends. This is where I really feel like I need it the most and where I see the most dryness. So I'm just going to rub my hands through it and get it really soaked in. I am going to add even more to the ends because I really want my ends to be moisturized. Now I'm just going to do a little bit on the top. I don't want too much at the top. Now my hair is pretty soaked with it. As you can see, I'm going to put a clip in and then let it sit for 30 minutes. I have 15 minutes left on the timer, so I wanted to do a little armpit detox while I wait. This is bentonite clay and it is perfect for detoxing, bringing all the toxins out. So I heard if you use this on your armpit, it can control the sweat and the smell. So I'm going to put this on while I wait for the timer. I am going to make it in this so it doesn't get super messy. I don't need too much, so I'm just going to put it on here. It is so soft, by the way. Honestly, I think that's too much, but I'm just going to add water in it. And then it looks like this. And then I'm just going to rub it on my armpits. I don't have an easier way to apply this, so it might get a little messy. Actually, I think I'm gonna go grab a glove first. Okay. Got the glove. Now this should be a little less messy because it was already getting all under my fingernails. This is extremely messy. Maybe I should have used a spoon or something. It is also dripping all over my counter. Okay, it is on both. I think this is good. It is dripping all over the floor. I definitely should have used something else. And I made it too wet, so don't put that much water in it. You definitely don't need so much water because now it's dripping everywhere. I'm going to let this sit and then I'm jumping in the shower. My shower is done. I use all natural products, so all of the products I use in the shower are non-toxic, no chemicals, no fragrances, and that's what I really like to use. I don't like putting any chemicals in my body. But now I'm just going to comb through my hair with a wide comb brush. It is not good to brush your hair after the shower with an actual brush, so a comb is good. I feel like I put a little too much coconut oil in my hair hair, so I can still kind of feel it, but I feel like that might be good. It could be used as a leave-in conditioner, so my hair will be really hydrated after this. But I am just going to comb through all my hair. Now I'm going to use my favorite skincare, and I actually just got these from TikTok shop, but I honestly love them. They are non-toxic and they smell so good. They are full of herbs. This one is a cleansing oil for normal skin, and I definitely have normal skin, maybe a little dry, but it has castor oil, avocado oil, pomegranate seed oil, essential oils, lavender, peppermint, rosemary, and vitamin E. So this is super good. So I am just going to cleanse my face with this. It smells so good. It smells like orange. And it says to use a hot rag after to put on your face and then really rub it in. So I'm gonna grab the hot towel. The warm rag is so nice. It feels like I'm at a spa, and I feel like it is also exfoliating at the same time. So this is definitely what my skin needed. Then I'm just going to go in with a toner. This one also has distilled water, aloe vera juice, witch hazel, raw unfiltered apple cider vinegar, magnesium oil, radish root, essential oils, and lavender. So this is also really nice. I just spray it all over my face, and then I break out along my chin, and I have a little bit of breakouts left. They are still healing, but they are trying to fade, and they always take so long to fade on me, and sometimes I get scars. So I'm gonna spray this really up close on them so that they can fade. I honestly just spray a lot and then just do a little dab. I am going to let this sit for a little bit and then I will be back. I am back. I ate some food so I wasn't starving while I do the teeth whitening. But first, I'm going to apply a serum. This is a plumping serum. It has pomegranate seed oil, rosehip seed oil, prickly pear seed oil, castor oil, maraca oil, green coffee, joji berry oil, essential oils of jasmine, frankincense, rosemary, carrot seed oil, rosemary extract, and vitamin E. So I am just going to put this on my skin. Then I'm gonna bring it down to my neck. I am now going to use my gua sha tool, and I'm not sure exactly how to do this. I just do it how I think. So I run it across my jaw and then down, and then I'm going to repeat these steps all a few times. I think it might help if you also hold your skin. Then I'm going to do it on this side as well. I think maybe I need to turn it. If anybody knows which side you put towards your face, let me know. Is it the longer side or the shorter side? I don't really know. I think you use the straight side for underneath your eye. Please correct me if I'm doing any of this wrong. I would love to learn. I don't even know if you do something there or not. Now I am going to let this sit for a little bit, put on the teeth whitening strips, and then I'm going to apply a face mask. I have the Crest 3D White strips, and I don't know how big they are, but I might cut them because I don't want it to go behind the back of my teeth because I don't want my teeth to get sensitive. Yeah, I think I'll probably cut it in half if I can get it open. It says you let these sit for an hour. Honestly, it's not that small. Should I cut it? Let me try and see how long it is first. I'll just do it. Oh, it's so cold. It looks crazy. And it's hard to talk because I have the whitening strips on. But this is a collagen mask. I'm just gonna rub it all in. Then I am going to squeeze out the remaining and put it on my neck. It says to keep the face mask on for 20 and the whitening strips for an hour. So I'm going to set my alarm for an hour and just take the face mask off whenever I feel like it. I am back. I can hardly talk. I have 21 minutes left for the teeth and I'm gonna take this off. I am so ready to get these off of my teeth. Finally, so much better. I will be using these more often. I have not used whitening strips in years and I want to get my teeth whitener. So this is something I'm going to start incorporating more often. But that is everything I am doing today for my self-care day. I will see you on Botox day. It is now Botox day and the only reason why I'm getting Botox today is because my surgeon's office is giving me 20 free units to use. I feel like the only wrinkle I notice when I smile, I get some crow's feet around my eyes. So that is what I think I'm going to do. Last time I went in and I tried to get it and I got super nervous and started freaking out. So I left and did not get it. So I'm going to try again today. Today is the last day I can get it because I had 6 months to use it. And of course I was too scared. So I waited till the very end. So now I either do it or I don't get the 20 free units and I feel like I should definitely use it because Botox is expensive. So if I can get it for free, I'll do it. But I have an issue with feigning. So I have been eating, drinking water. I have a protein shake to eat. I got apple juice and I heard that if you tense your muscles, it'll help you not faint. So I'm going to be prepared. I'm going to bring ice packs. I'm going to do everything I can to not faint because feigning is super traumatizing and I don't want it to happen. But I will show you guys the process and what it looks like after. It takes 3 to 5 days to actually work and then you should see the full effects in 2 weeks. So I will keep updating and let you guys know what it looks like. There is a TV going in the background, so just ignore that, but they just numbed next to my eyes, so I'm gonna sit in here for a few minutes for the numbing to kick in, and then we will be good to go.
The numbing cream area works so
well. Yeah.
You don't feel dizzy, okay. Anything like that. So okay. Just stay seated for at least a few more minutes.
Okay.
And when you feel fine, then you can get up and just check out what happens.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. I feel fine.
It wasn't bad?
That was not bad at all. I think I came more prepared so I wasn't as nervous. And she did it so quick and it honestly felt easier than a shot in your arm. I could feel it, but it wasn't bad. It was just like a poke. This helped and drinking water all day and this rag. I think this rag is what helped a lot. Okay, so she finished. She did 1, 2, 3 dots around my eyes and then the same side on the other side. We did 8 units per side, so I got 16 units total. And honestly, she did it so fast, I couldn't really feel it. And I did not feel faint at all, so the fans and drinking water all day helped. Plus, it just felt easier. She did it so fast. This was easy. It'll kick in between 3 to 6 days, but then I'll see the full effects on 2 to 3 weeks. It is now nail day. These are my nails before. I just got a milky white on them. This time, I think I want to do a really light pink. So I wore a light pink, of course, to match so I can get some cute pictures after. I always get builder gel on my nails. And if you don't know what that is, it is a step up from plain gel. Gel doesn't harden your nails, but builder gel hardens your nails so they will not break. My nails are so hard and they've grown out so long from this since they do not break and they don't get brittle. So if you haven't tried builder gel, I highly suggest it. It feels just like acrylics, but it is healthier for your nails since you're actually using your real nail. They will grow out this long. I love them. It looks like I have fake nails on, but it's just my nails. So that is what I get every single time. I started going to a new place last time, so I will be going here for my second time. The place is so cute and they give you a complimentary drink, so I think I'm gonna get a cute little refreshing mocktail today. Also, it has been 4 days since I got the Botox done and it has definitely kicked in. Whenever I squinch my eyes, I don't see any wrinkles, so I'm gonna show you guys. So this is me squinching a little bit, squinching really hard. Obviously you're gonna have some more up here, but I used to have some like right here and those don't really show up anymore, but it's supposed to kick in more and more up to 2 weeks, so I will definitely keep updating and show you guys what it looks like in a few more days. I'm excited to see what else it's gonna look like, but I was so scared to get it because I heard that it'll mess with your cheek or your smile, and I don't really notice that happening to me, so I think she must have put it in the right areas and she knew what she was doing. So it's so important to go to a place that knows how to do their injectables. Don't try to go somewhere cheap. You definitely need a professional for this, but I'm going to take you along to get my nails done. Are done. It took 3 hours, but the owner gave me a mocktail and some trail mix. He was so sweet. I got very light pink and I love them. It is now eyelash extension day. My eyelashes are looking so bare because my eyes have been bothering me, so a lot of lashes came out. So I'm gonna go get a fill today. I always get hybrid, which is a mix between classic and volume lashes. I always go to the same girl. She is so good. I always get cat eye. Also, my Botox has 100% kicked in, so I'm gonna show you guys again. This is me smiling and then squinting. There's no crow's feet, so I am loving the results. I am going to run to my appointment now and I will take you guys with me. I am done with my lashes. Here's how they look. And I'm done with all my appointments, so I'm gonna end the vlog here. Thank you guys so much for watching my glow up. And comment down below and tell me what you like to do to glow up. And also give me a like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.